We are making confetti croissants with strawberry buttercream.
Nice.
Wow.
So beautiful. We're going to make it easy. We're going to start with store-bought puff pastry, which cut into strips and then into triangles. So we're not using croissant dough. We're cheating. And now we'll shape the croissants.
I know this is fancy, but people can make this at home. This is no big
so
deal, right?
This is so easy to make at home.
We're sharing a knife, by the way, Kellie and I.
I mean, I don't trust you with sharp objects.
I don't either.
I know, right?
I don't either.
So to form the croissant, you cut a little slit so you can pull it, and then you basically just roll it up, right? Like a pig in a blanket.
Okay. Yeah.
And you want to make sure the tip is tucked under because you don't want it to pop up.
Okay. Right.
And then you bring the corners together like a hug, all right?
Oh,
like
we're going to hug
hugging.
It.
Oh, hug your croissant, right?
Hug it.
Pinch it.
Hug it out.
Okay, and now the confetti part.
Pinch it together.
Pinch.
Paint it together. Is this butter?
This is egg white.
So
this is the glue that will hold
these
sprinkles to it. Okay. So give it a hearty brushing.
Okay.
Now, how did you become a pastry chef?
Well, my mother's vegan, and it was my ultimate act of rebellion.
Oh, nice. Yeah.
Nothing else works.
You got to do that, right?
I'm glad you didn't set the house on fire. You just went into pastries. That's nice.
I mean, I did that, too. I set the house on fire, too. But apparently, when you reheat a pizza, you're supposed to take it out of the box.
Oh, yeah, yeah. And the tin foil.
Yeah.
Okay, and then we dip it in our little sprinkles?
Dip it in the sprinkles. And you want full coverage, because what will happen is, as it bakes, the layers will separate, and you'll get this really cool striping effect.
It's like Bozo the Clown's smile. Right now.
It's fine. I mean, hey, croissants can come in all shapes and sizes.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
They're like, nice. Right? really strong work.
I suck at everything.
No, you don't.
I can't even fold a croissant.
So we will bake these at 375 for about 18 to 20 minutes. And meanwhile, we'll make the buttercream. So this is a Swiss style buttercream, Swiss meringue. So it's not like the powdered sugar and butter, you know, that hurts your teeth.
Yeah.
Right.
So you heat your egg white and your sugar just until it's hot and it dissolves.
Uh-huh.
And then put it in your mixer and whisk it until it's cool.
Wonderful.
And we have this done.
Oh, wow.
See how
is that what it looks
fluffy.
Like?
Yeah, that's what it looks like. And now we got to put the butter in the buttercream. So we have our unsalted butter, which we'll add.
Unsalted butter.
People
now, did you go to pastry chef school?
I did go to pastry chef school. I went to school in New York, and I also went to France for a bit to learn.
Oh, nice.
Hence, you know, croissants.
Yes.
Right.
So whisk this on high until it's smooth and fluffy, and then we will add strawberry jam.
Wow.
Salt, a little kosher salt, because salt really brings out the sweetness, right? And then to enhance that strawberry, this is lime juice.
Lime juice.
A
little bit of lime. It's gonna make it pop, right? Okay. Almost like, you know, like that candy strawberry.
Uh-huh.
And it also cuts through the fat of the buttercream.
Right.
So now we whisk it.
Tell us about Winner Cake All.
So Winner Cake All, really fun cake competition.
Uh-huh.
Every episode, there's a new special guest. So everyone from like Rashad Jennings to like the original Broadway Disney princesses.
Nice.
Best day ever. Oh my God, all right. So,
all right.
We're gonna fill our croissants now.
Yes, we're gonna fill.
Right.
So make
look
a little
there.
Little X.
Incision.
Yeah, so you can squeeze and then you
see, I could be a doctor.
That's right.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Pastry surgery.
Do you do it on both sides or just
one? You can do it on both sides, you can do it on one side, you can do it wherever you can get
I don't know what I'm doing.
Kellie doing surgery in that hat.
Yeah.
You wake up from anesthesia.
So your croissant is filled, right?
It's filled. Ben,
and you can see. We'll just
here,
do that.
You fill my
here,
croissant.
Catch this.
Yeah.
Sorry.
So you can see just enough filling to
that's awesome.
Pop it out.
All right.
It must be so fun to combine different pastries together.
It is. I mean, that was kind of the pie kicking was it's pie, it's
here's
cake.
Here's your croissant.
You know, we do cheesecakes. And my other favorite thing is we do what we call zacaroons, which are my version of
zacaroons.
Got to name something after
yourself. I love it. Totally.
So we did, for Valentine's Day, we have a Drunken Love zacaroon collection.
Oh, nice.
Cocktail inspired. And we're shipping them nationwide, too.
That's
great
wonderful.
Valentine's Day present.
All right, let's taste these.
Let's do it.
Here, cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers, cheers Betty.
Cheers.
Cheers. The fancy things. Thank you, Zac Young. You can see Zac on Food Network's Winner Cake All Monday nights at 10 Eastern. And don't forget, all the treats you see here you can find at the Piecaken Bake Shop.